Hello again. This is the Waterman Spiritual Toolbox number 110, the Love Chapter number 86, audio recording number 428, examination table number 90. Okay. Now we're going to continue in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8. All right. Now, in the King James language, it says, charity never faileth, but whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. Okay. Now, we covered the other part all the way down to whether there be prophecies, okay, and they shall fail. Okay, and it's not like it's failing. It's just that the aid from the prophecies has helped aid that person in making the right decisions to where they're taking a thought process, an area of their thought process all the way through that eye of the needle, and that's got back E-M-S-Y-N God and relit. God has relit it. Back, they worked out their own salvation. There's aid as it's aiding them. All it's doing is it's aiding, helping them make the decision. It's not making decisions to agree or disagree for them, but it's pointing the way. It's helping them. It's aiding, like a spiritual toolbox or something. It's helping. Okay? If they study and they're living it out, and it's becoming their gospel. And seeing all this is just in one little thought process out of a whole myriad of thought processes. And there's a whole bunch. So at the end of each one of them, when you're getting that thought process all the way down to E-N-S-Y-N, God is holding it tightly. It's not getting away. It can't fall away. Not any longer. Okay? It's reunited, and the fuel coming from that reunited little star inside of them, that light, the Christ side of them, is fueled by God. Nobody can put that out. Okay? But there's a whole bunch more to get. So that job of that prophecies, that being aided, is like unemployed in this area, they're thinking now. It's that rendered entirely idle. It's not needed. You know, so that, because then now they're able in that one area that's lit up to aid others as the Spirit leads, not as they decide because there's a need out there. Because you see someone just misinterpreting what God's doing, what the Word of God, what His thought processes are, that God's a great hero, and He's not going to kill, not torment nobody. But this torment that they're thinking is just those pressures that's taken to get that thought process there. Okay? Because God's changing the inside the way you think. Put on the mind of the Christ. Not stay in your old stinking righteousness. Not tell you just what you already believe. No, that don't do you no good. That's like letting them tiptoe through the tulips and be dumber than a rock. And that's what you need. No, it's not. Come on, man. You're not being baptized by that. The Holy Spirit, God Himself, is giving the increase. That's what you're being baptized. He's boiling that waters in your mind. And He's bringing you, submerging you, baptizing, baptism of the Holy Spirit in that vinegar solution, that bitter, awful, harsh stuff. Calamities and tribulations and fire trials are boiling up that water, right? Boiling up your thought processes. Earthquaking going on in there in that mind of ours. You know, now that's gonna bring about a part, and I'm gonna I've been wrestling where to go on doing this or not. God gave me this a little bit earlier. But that heat, like, thing in there. What heat is like, if you take, like, down, say, in the atoms or the little molecules, down real, real tiny, it's vibrating, moving. And the faster it moves, the hotter it gets, the faster it moves. So when God's, that's in the physical. Now, in the spiritual, as God's putting these pressures, this thalipsis, in the world there must be tribulation. Pressures. Thalipsis. But be of good cheer, for I have overcome the world. This orderly arrangement in the mind of humanity. This cosmos thinking. This great big old universe of a mind. Just like looking like you're looking out here. All right? He's changing. Okay? Change the way you think. Okay? Now, heat. It's just little bit pixels and stuff that's down in there vibrating. Say there's a little, an atom. We'll just take an atom, which is like a little ball. Okay? And it's vibrating. And it's got, right in the center of it, it's got that seed of faith that God put a limited portion in all, in everyone. Pass. Leave no one out. Okay? But it's a tiny little, it's 1 e to the 35, negative 35. It's super, super, super small. Okay? Take point, or take a 1 and move the decimal point 35 times out there, or out to the left, I'm sorry, to the left. You move it once on a 1, it's 0.1, 1/10. Move it twice, 1/100. Move it 3 times, you got 1/1000th. It's like taking one little thought process and cutting it 1,000 times. We're speaking spiritually thinking in your mind, your spiritual thinking. God's working in your mind. Get your mind right, right? God's doing this for you with these fiery trials. Okay? And with these pressures, these tribulations. Take that thought process down through the eye of the needle, down through that funnel. Pressurizing you, not tiptoeing through the tulips. No, he's boiling that water, just like changing a cucumber into a pickle, baptismo. Okay, not just this water baptizing stuff out here that's just based upon you saying, "Okay, God," and then next week do the same thing again, water baptized. No, bapto. No, this is much deeper. God's doing this baptism of the Holy Spirit. Okay? So that you can no longer speak dog language, beast nature. When you brought up a cucumber, in that thought process, you're speaking the spiritual language of God. You're actually communicating when you're all the way E-N and S-Y-N, God. You don't need language. These tongues, you're communicating with God. Your mind's been changed in this area. Okay? Now, this pickle, or this cucumber being changed into a pickle, taken down into boiling water. And this vinegar solution, real bitter and harsh. God's thrashing it. Shall we crunch up this humanistic thinking, my child? Yes, sir. Daddy. Hi-ya! Chop it out. Transform it into his image. He spins it a little bit. Shall we do it again? Yes, sir. Daddy, I give up on that stuff. I don't want it. Yuck. Whack. He chopped all that wood and that humanistic thinking out. Then he pulls up stuff inside you, this presumptuous, sinful nature inside you. In this one little area of your thought process. One little pixel. I have a whole myriad of thinking ways you think. And he's taking this, and then he's melting it out. Shall we skim this stuff out and throw it away, put that in the garbage? Yes, sir, Daddy. Skim this stuff out. Yes, sir, Father God. Emphatically. You're excited to get rid of that stuff because you can't do it yourself. Anytime in this stuff you say no, uh-oh. They're subsiding away, falling away from God. They're not proceeding back into the love of God, back into God's righteousness, God's right-mindedness. You're not heading in the right direction. You're not getting the increase of God. No matter how much of your own efforts of good and evil stuff, you're not going back into God at all. It's ooh yuck. Anything but being in hot pursuit of God and in agreement, you're not going on. No matter how much hot this gets. And believe me, it gets hotter and hotter and hotter. Because just like in that heat, it's vibrating as it gets the little like atoms in the natural vibrating. As it gets hotter, they vibrate more. Can you imagine when it's getting down to that presumptuous stuff and that refiner's fire, when it's vibrating really, really harsh, and then one of those impurities floats up to the top of that refiner's pot from all of this little thought process. Whoa, that thing's vibrating like a daggone mad dog. Out comes a little bit of that darkness up to the top. Ooh, yuck, that's awful. So we try to chop that stuff up. Out, do you give out? You see it? Do you understand that this is not of me? This is not right-mindedness. Yes, sir, daddy, skim this stuff off. I don't want it. Not, oh, I'm sorry, and then go right to it, back to it, like a dog returning to its own vomit. God's not watching now. No, no, no. That's not being in hot pursuit. That's disagreeing. You're not going to slip one over on God. Not possible. You can't slip one over the omnipotent, omnipresent one, the sovereign God, the one who's in control of all things. You're not going to pull this over on the Spirit of God. That's not possible. That's stupid. That's the dog. That's that humanistic self-righteousness of yours thinking you can. If you believe that stuff, up, go right around the mountain. You know, if God doesn't permit you to be able to see, hear, taste, touch, and smell, if that's daggone yuck, yeah, you'll be stuck. You can't go no more. So it's an opportunity to get rid of it. Shall we crowd chop this stuff out and burn it up? Shall we? That's a consuming fire. Shall we melt this stuff out in this refiner's pot? He's working on this little ball of your thinking processes, okay? This little area, your thinking process, getting rid of that soul-y stuff. See, that soul-y stuff is this little bit of the spirit in there with all that dark, yucky, poopy thinking of your own right-mindedness. What does the Word of God do? It separates the spirit and the soul, okay? From your seeing, hearing, taste, touch, or smell, controlled by that ego, emotions. Just crazy. Instead of being grounded, being quick to hear what God is saying and agreeing with God into this love, into the joy, into those emotions. Being controlled, that's a real gift. Instead of all this bull crap, good and bad, good and bad. Spit out that strong lizard. So you got to agree with God. Skim this stuff off, daddy. Chop this stuff out. It's a long process to get that one little thought process through there. All the way back in and that's right in God. And then relight it. God's doing the relighting. He's doing all the work. The battle is the Lord's. To get all the way in God. Remember, that's resting in God. It's God doing it all. It's not by your might, or your power, or your strength, or anything, but just agreeing with God. Yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, daddy. I want my bags full. I want my mind full of you, of your right-mindedness. I'm in worshiping you. Now, that worship is not just sing and do the do dance, or lift hands or do something, that's okay. But that's not what, if you're not doing it in here, agreeing wholeheartedly with God and proceeding back in there. In the harshest times of your life, in the storms of your life, you've got to agree with God. That's worship. Being in awe of God. Oh, God, you're right. You're correct. Skim this stuff off. Chop this stuff out. I love you. Be in the good, bad, the ugly, anything. Rest in God, just like Noah's name means. No matter what, rest in God. That's E-N-I-N, right? E-N's the Koine Greek. Okay, for that. And it means resting in God. Okay, and S-Y-N, in union with God. In union with God is my greatest hero. God is the exceeding great reward. He's the one that satisfied me. When I reach out with my efforts, God satisfies me. Yes. All else is poopy thinking or nothing there. It's grasping after the wind. Just like King Solomon was talking about. In Ecclesiastes, and I'm pretty sure in Song of Solomon too. Okay? I mean, I go on. Okay, now this heat, it's been, okay, it's really getting it hot, right? And it's vinegar, so it's bitter stuff. Okay, it's taking out this stuff, this nasty poop thinking in you. And you got to agree with that. Agree, agree, agree. Shall we crotty chop this board? Shall we take it out? Shall we do this? Shall we skim this stuff off of you? Out of your mind? Out of this one area, are you giving up on this? Are you surrendering all? A little bit by little bit by little bit. Line upon line, precept upon precept. A little bit of this, a little bit of that. A little bit of that dark thinking. God's purifying, purifying, purifying. Make God true. Acknowledge God is the truth. And all this humanistic crap is wrong. My own righteousness is as filthy, stinking, this mistress rags. I count it all as dung for winning Christ. Okay? It's not like, but, God. Okay, go back out there. You're not convinced yet. And it doubles. See, it either doubles falling into God. God gives the increase. It's adding to you. Or it's a but. It's on the contrary, and you're going back out. And it's double, and again, in troubles, double trouble. Falling away, getting more poop, gotta go through it more. It's getting tougher and tougher. Okay, it's like an adverse sentence. Huh, you're doing it to yourself because you're not agreeing with God. But there, even then, there's still a speck in there, but it's not getting increased. Unless you agree with God, you can only get there one way, the truth and the life. That's the way Jesus did it. You can't go back to God unless you be born again. See, God's rebirthing there. Every thought process, one right after another, repeatedly baptizing. That's baptismo. Change that cucumber in the boiling water, down in the vinegar solution. Man, it's harsh until it's changed to God's standards. Not till you give up, but till you give up over and 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 turn back to God. And then he said, okay, we're done. Bring this up. And that's now he lights it into a little fire. A little star is fusing. Okay? Now that little bitty, like picks, a little bitty ball, a little tiny, tiny ball. A fire, a little star down in your universe of mine is baptized. Baptismo is changed like it from a cucumber thinking, your carnal thinking, right back EM and SYN to this pickle thinking of God. Okay? And then it goes to do another one and another one and another one because you got a myriad of those things. Okay? Now, in a storm's life, you get to choose. Yes or no. I agree with you, God, or I disagree, okay? Now, in the natural things go from something hot, transfers heat to something that's cold. Something hot for God. It's got a lot of spiritual vibrating, like just like God baptizing there. Okay? You're hot for God, and God is your strong tower. You're in God. You're like inside that star, but God's protecting you. No worries. The natural stuff can't even exist in there. Like your old earth suit here wouldn't last no time. Couldn't. It's absolutely not allowed by God. Can't. There's lots of pressure and lots of fire in that fusing star, but it's like in your mind. It's real, real tiny. Those thought processes, just like the stars up here in the universe. That outward stuff is teaching you about what's going on in here and where's God working inside of you. First, seek ye first the time, place, and order of importance, the kingdom of God that's ruling around that Basileia. You don't have to like punch your ticket and tiptoe through the tulips and wait for something. You're not going to get very far that way. Let's look at external. And if you're looking that way, well then, still love you. But that's not going to make you a heavier, denser, more denser element. Or, you know, in God. You're not going to get more glory of God doing that. If you want more of God, you got to agree. But he's got to permit you to be able to see, hear, taste, touch, and smell it with Christ in control. Be quick to hear what God says and obey it. And so to speak, so to react to all this crap with this barking alpha dog and all this carnality, this non-spiritual mind of ours. Just telling us, you got to shut that thing up. Put a muzzle on it. Be quiet. Be still. Okay? Now, let me see if I can get through this thing here. Or get started. Now, this, in the natural, there's entropy. That's like when you got something hot up here, and the heat goes to something cold. It escapes out to the cold. It's drawn out of it. So, whenever you, like, you bring out something, if you have something, a big, hot, boiling pot of water, your thought process. You put it out here in the natural, and that thing cools down. It goes colder, it grows colder and colder and colder, right? Now, being hot would be like being spiritually minded in Christ, being like E in God, right? In the natural, it's going colder, like going into this, towards the absolute zero, where it's not even moving. Those atoms and stuff in there are not even moving. They're slowing down. And like that movement, that energy, that spirit of God is moving like crazy. That thing's hotter than all get out. All right? But in the natural, everything's going from hot to cold. It's cooling down. You leave a big pot of water, real hot boiling water, and then you turn off the heat to it. You leave it there for a few hours, that thing will get colder and colder till it's like at room temperature or whatever. If it's outside and it's like 10 degrees outside, that thing's going to freeze to ice, right? That's in the natural, okay? It's going from an ordered state, like it's everything moving, to a very disordered. That's what entropy is. In short, it's going to, from the hot to a cold, okay? From like in the spiritual to the non-spiritual. Go from the spirit of God's right-mindedness right into that. Now, that's the natural way. If you sow to the flesh, you reap corruption. Okay? If you eat of that tree of knowledge of good and evil, you shall surely die. You will be separated from God. Okay? You're going this natural thing and you're getting colder. Gotta spit you out of his mouth. You can't go on in through the eye of the needle doing that. Now, as you're in the spirit, that's disagreeing with God. That happens. When you disagree in these eyes of a storm, you grow colder, from hot to cold. Or when you're green, you're getting hotter, and then all of a sudden, you disagree, or you doubt God, or you don't go in hot pursuit. Cold, back out, do it again. Okay? Now, as you're agreeing with God in hot pursuit, with God's righteousness, God's love beyond words, and you're falling from all this old poop thinking back into EN and SYN, God's righteousness, God's love beyond words, you grow increasingly hotter and brighter, glowing bright, all the way back when once your EN and SYN got it, lights into us like a star, like a fire. Just like God's a consuming fire and a refiner, you become the exact representation of God. Right? It's resting in God. God's protecting you. It's not natural, not in the non-spiritual mind. Can't go there. It's enmity with God. See, in carnal mind goes from hot to cold, and the Spirit of God goes from cold, this carnal thing that you were subjected to, not willingly, but in hope, and bring it right back into an ordered state, right back in God, heating it up. God's adding His love beyond words, His fire, He's putting fire in you. To where you're moving, you got that Spirit in you. That Spirit is coming alive in you. Those seeds of faith are coming back. They're germinating and coming back to life. Okay? Now, I got about 5 minutes left, so I need to get on the ball here. So, in the Spirit, these things grow increasingly hotter and brighter. This ball of thinking, right, that God's working on one at a time, one area at a time, it's growing from out of this poop thinking, all this cold stuff, right back EN, the SY, and God. It's growing hotter and hotter and hotter, and it takes the time. And it's going to be put through this lot of pressures, fire trials, this heat, this tribulation, ellipsis, and then that fiery trials, okay? Bringing you right back into God, okay? Right back in this way in God, okay? This igniting this fire of God, in this way in God, is like the fusion in a star that's fusing stuff, squeezing it together, just like God holding you in the nucleus, tighter in the nucleus than the protons and electrons. Protons and neutrons are held by the strong nuclear force in the nucleus of an atom more securely. God's funneling you down through there. Once you're in there, man, it's like, boom, you're on fire. His ministers is a flame of fire, right? It's inside. All right? It's that love of God. It's that love beyond words, okay? It's a star within one's mind, okay? And it's like your mind's like the observable universe, really scaled down. It's, you know, it's like the observable universe, like 93 billion light years. Holy cow. Right? And that's in me. And then Lisa's got an observable universe in her. And so we don't even know most of it in there. That Spirit, those seeds cry out with things, they utter things that we don't even know about. Read the Romans chapter 8, verse 22 through 28, right in that area, okay? Telling you about that, okay? Now, this is within the observable universe of one's own mind that this ball thinking, the star ignites and burns bright, permanently fixed, EN and SYN, the self-existent, fuel of God beyond God's love. It's fueled by God. It's not just going to burn till all the wood's burned up, like all the garbage is burned up out. You're burning garbage out there, and then it goes out because there's no more fuel there. No, God's fuel, He's a self-existent one. It goes on and on and on. It's permanently held, okay? Now, so this is like spiritually returning back to the EN and SYN God. to that love beyond words. And it's going like the disorder of one's own carnality is heading back into the order of God's spiritual oneness, being one with God. Being back in and S-Y-N, God's righteousness, God's right-mindedness, thinking the way God thinks. Put on the mind of Christ. God's bringing you in, resting in God. And S-Y-N, in union with God's right-mindedness. Boom, it's like you're a flame of fire, like a little tiny star in there. And it's in each and every different thought process. There's a whole bunch in there. However many seeds God has put in you. But they're just potentials. Until you go through, agree, chop out that stuff in me. Melt out that stuff in me. Oh, and skim it off, please. Yes. And take me back in to you. Okay. All right. So this is entropy. Fleshly, natural entropy going from hot to cold. Spiritual entropy going from your carnality, which is cold, back in, that's why in God, which is hot. But see, you're in God. He's your rock, your strong tower. He's your all in all. He's for protection. Okay? All right, that was Spiritual Toolbox number 110. Okay, I'll continue later, and I'll continue back in 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 8. I'll just put that out there, okay? Bye-bye.